Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Morgan Talks Girl and I'm obsessed with all things beauty and skincare related. Today we are going to be talking about Glow Recipes Pineapple C Bright Serum for brightening and smoothing, you guys, right here. Now, Glow Recipe has been such a popular brand at Sephora for the last couple of years now. Wow, I used a lot of this. I'm already down to here. Anyway, I knew of Glow Recipe and what I believe, I mean, you know, this could be up for debate, but what really, first of all, Glow Recipe was sold at Sephora, but I think the moment that Glow Recipe was really put on the map is when Jeffree Star was doing one of his videos and he put the watermelon sleep mask and he literally so casually brought it up. He was just kind of like, I don't know what this is. It's like Glow Recipe, but it makes my skin feel so nice. And then I think slowly after that, influencers started getting more introduced to it and the brand just kind of blew up. It's all over Sephora. Everybody pretty much knows the Glow Recipe brand. The watermelon sleeping mask and then of course their blueberry cleanser were the first two big products on the market, and then of course they started capitalizing off of other ideas and the brand is like a full-blown beauty brand today that people love. K-Beauty brand, a Korean beauty brand that specializes in like fruit extracts, cruelty-free, safe from harsh chemical products that, and they're very proud of that, and they are considered clean at Sephora. Now, you guys, what is clean at Sephora? If you're like me, I would see that and be like, oh, that's good. They have like the stamp of clean at Sephora, but nowhere could I find what it actually took to be clean at Sephora. So I did find it on the website today. It looks like they've actually updated their website in explaining that just a little more for us. So clean at Sephora is formulated without a list of over 50 ingredients, including sulfates, parabens, and phthalates and more. For the full list, check out the ingredients tab. So, okay, good to know. Let's talk about this little beauty. This is supposed to be infused with pineapple juice, chamomile for soothing, and then of course vitamin C for the antioxidants. And supposedly the pineapple juice is supposed to give your skin the appearance of brighter skin, as of course we all know who really does the job there, and that's the vitamin C. Period. Now the packaging of this is adorable, you guys. It is a little glass pineapple and then it comes out in this dropper form. Here it is right here. You get, and I love like the font here. It's just very, the packaging is so extra and then the font is straight to the point, very clean. I'm a big fan of this. Also, you get one fluid, oh my God, I have something in my throat. No, I don't have coronavirus, girl. Girl, I can't even function under these conditions. Oh, you guys, I'm a little bit like Ariana Grande-like today. I've always been more of like, hit me baby one more time, Britney Jean status, but I've always loved a good half up, half down pony, but if I was to ever embody anybody, it would be Britney Jean. Miss Britney Jean Spears, that's for damn sure, so don't get it twisted. Now, the price of this is $49 for one fluid ounce. Oh, guys, Glow Recipe, come on, girl. Vitamin C's should not be that expensive. You could literally go on Amazon and buy a vitamin C for like $10 to $15, like max, and $50. This is similar to like my idea of like the Peter Thomas Roth Hyaluronic Cloud Dream Serum, where they were charging, I think, even more. But $50 is very steep for a product like this with these types of ingredients. However, you're gonna get the whole package. You're gonna get you're buying Glow Recipe, the it brand of the moment, one of the current it brands at the moment, and you're getting this really pretty packaging and the pineapple experience. Now, the only thing that I have to say about this product that's kind of helps that price point is their ingredients are packed with the good stuff right at the top of the list. Thank you, God, we are not having a Shiseido Wasso moment. Girl, they're true to their word when it comes to Glow Recipe, and I'm gonna read you some of the ingredients. Their highlighted ingredients are the pineapple juice, the vitamin C, and the chamomile. They are what they are promoting, right? It's three big ingredients, right? So when you first look at their ingredients list, first ingredient on the list, pineapple fruit extract. Number one, for those of you guys who don't know, the first 5 to 10 ingredients are primarily what the skincare product is made out of. I personally like to just really focus on the 5 because let's just be real here. So first ingredient, pineapple juice. Second ingredient is a type of alcohol, not a bad alcohol. Alcohols do have a place in the skincare world. Don't panic when you see alcohols on an ingredients list. The ones you should be more concerned about are like the denatured alcohols. They're okay, but make sure they're low. Make sure they're bottom of the list. If they're one of the top ones, girl, you have something to worry about. Shiseido. You have your water. Girl, water, H2O, yes, water. Then ascorbic acid, dimethicone, and then more ascorbic acid. The ascorbic acid is another word for vitamin C. Vitamin C, right? Boom. Then lactic acid, sodium hyaluronate, which is hyaluronic acid. I mean, these are like all the ingredients listed in the beginning. And then, of course, the camellia flower extract, the chamomile. And then after that, it's aloe. Aloe leaf juice. Like, girl, squalene. I mean, I'm loving it. Safflower seed, I'm loving it. Girl. I'm loving it. So you guys, this is one of the best first list of ingredients that I've seen in a product in a while. So shout out Glow Recipe. Thank you. You know what? I really do want to take this time to just thank the brand of Glow Recipe. Thank you for making the ingredients that you're promoting the most as number one in your ingredients list. You guys, let's just give them a moment because there is so much BS that goes on in the skincare community and beauty community where they're promoting, and they're at the bottom of the list. If you want to see an example of that, please go check out the Shiseido Wasso gel cream. Just read those ingredients and what's number one and what's last. You know, I don't like that. I don't respect that. So the fact that they're being straight up and putting the good stuff first, we live. Now let's open her up. First off, what I want to say is before I begin, vitamin C's are best stored in dark, cool places to help them maintain their potency. Now, vitamin C dies very, very easy, which is why I think having a skincare mini fridge in your bathroom, not in your refrigerator next to the produce and the meat because that's unsanitary. This is the time where I think a skincare mini fridge could come into play, storing your sensitive acids. But one thing I do need to say is when I put this product in my skincare mini fridge, it like thickened the product up and I couldn't squeeze it out of the dropper. I couldn't squeeze it out. So I unfortunately need to store this on my countertop. Another thing that I'm noticing about the ingredients list, although everything's straight up, right? Everything's straight up. We love the ingredients. There is no, like, I don't see preservatives in the beginning of the ingredients list that's going to preserve the vitamin C that this is so packed with. So, like, I feel bad for skincare companies because it's kind of like a catch-22. You've loaded up with preservatives to you know, maintain the vitamin C, but then you're getting yelled at for having way too many preservatives. And then you don't put that many preservatives like this product and everyone's like, well, the vitamin C is going to die really quick. So it's kind of like a lose-lose situation, and we're gonna find a happy balance. The packaging is hard glass, we're living. So let's take it out of its little thing. So it comes out in this dropper form. I squeeze it to bring the product up. You could see it in the dropper now, done. And then what I also wanna let you know, if you look in this packaging, you could see like there's like this plastic thing that conceals it more. I don't know if you could see that in the camera, but there's a plastic thing within this glass packaging that helps tighten the ingredients more. So I do appreciate that, and that's probably helping the vitamin C stay alive longer. So, okay, so here it is. You just, look at that texture. Boom, loving it. Okay, so here it is on my fingertips. I'm gonna put some on the back of my hands, but not too much. Now, it does have a lovely scent of pineapple. It is not overbearing. It does not smell like fragrance. It actually smells pretty natural, probably because it is primarily made up of pineapple juice. Here's my skin up close. So let's start working this into my skin. You guys, I love this product when applying it to my skin because it glides very easy. It is slightly tacky, but not gross tacky. And I'm just gonna put a little extra for my forehead. And look at that, you guys. You could see that shine, that glow, I shall say, that is just going all throughout my skin. Ugh, what a lovely, lovely serum. So now it's applied. You guys let me know what you guys think. Right now my skin is super, super soft and like nicely glowy. It does not feel greasy at all. Okay, so the skin types that Glow Recipe recommends this product for is normal skin types, dry, combination, and oily. For irritated skin, I don't even know if that's like an option on the Sephora website, like irritated or sensitive skin. I think it is. They didn't list sensitive skin. Quite honestly, I don't really know why, because I think if you do have sensitive skin, I think you're gonna like this product. It's gonna be hit or miss, but I think most of you will actually like it. I think the reason why is, one, vitamin C could be quite irritating for sensitive skin people. It can cause breakouts and it could make your skin react a certain way. Vitamin C, it's just some people break out from it, and I've had from bad vitamin C's in the past. However, this product, I have not. See why that would be a problem? The reviews I read on this on Sephora.com, they were very hit or miss, up and down. Some I agreed with, some I didn't. It seems to me, finally, a brand does it right. It gives you the ingredients that you want, right? Some people break out from it, right? It could be a little pore clogging. I've been noticing that the products that are made of shitty ingredients have the best reviews. And because a lot of these skincare brands and products are so filled with skin softeners and skin, like stuff that's gonna topically make your skin feel smoother than what it really is. Kind of like the Shiseido Wasso cream. It feels great going on your skin. You love it. You feel like it makes your skin so soft and nice, but it's loaded with junk that's just topically making that happen. Over time, it's not gonna benefit your skin. It's just gonna give you an instant gratification, satisfaction. We want products that, okay, maybe we're not gonna get instant results, but over time, your skin is gonna be beaming and it's gonna look gorgeous. So just be mindful of that. Give certain good products a try. Everybody, this product passes for me. I don't like the price of it. Still 50 bucks, although loaded with like honest ingredients. I think you're paying a lot for the brand, but I would still purchase it if you have the money to splurge, if you really want to. I'm not gonna sway anybody against purchasing it because I actually really like this serum and I don't say things like this lightly. Everybody, that's what I have to say. I mean, this skincare actually passes for Morgan Talks. Everybody, oh, and if you're wondering, I do use this primarily in the mornings. I love a good vitamin C right in the morning. Wake me up, girl. Everybody have a great day. If you haven't done so, subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram, follow me on TikTok, and you guys just have a great, healthy day. I love you, and until next time, stay moisturized, stay bright, stay healthy. Love you. Bye.